Namaste. Welcome, dear farmer friends, to the special episode of Kisan Seva on crop production in sugarcane. Sugarcane farmers are facing a variety of pest and disease incidences at different crop growth period. We have received a handful number of queries from sugarcane farmers from all over the country. Today, we have a team of eminent scientists to answer your queries. I take this opportunity to introduce them. Meet Dr. Chandrika, Principal Scientist and Head Division of Entomology, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, New Delhi. Welcome you, ma'am. We have Dr. Parida, Director, Indian Institute of Sugarcane Research, Lucknow. Welcome you, sir. We also have Dr. Prabhulinga, Professor and Head, Department of Entomology, University of Agricultural Sciences, Dharwad. Welcome you, sir. Meet Dr. Pradeep Kumar, Principal Scientist and Head, Division of Genetics and Plant Breeding, Sugarcane Breeding Institute, Coimbatore. Welcome you, sir. We have Dr. Nitika, Principal Scientist and Head, Division of Plant Pathology, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, New Delhi. Welcome you, madam. Today, we have Dr. Piyashi Debroy, Principal Scientist, Division of Entomology, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, New Delhi. Welcome you, madam. We also have Dr. Prakash Sharma, Professor and Head, Division of Entomology, Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, Coimbatore. Welcome you, sir. It is my pleasure to welcome Dr. Panjavarnam, Division Principal Scientist, Division of Agronomy, Indian Institute of Sugarcane Research, Lucknow. Sugarcane is one of the most important cash crop of our country, but the productivity is being affected due to various pest and disease incidences. So, farmer friends, we shall begin today's special program with your queries on production aspects to our experts. So first letter is from Yellappa of Gulbarga district of Karnataka. He has observed white patches on the lower surface of leaves and canes with short internodes. Dr. Chandrika, can you please throw some light on the issue and help Yellappa ji?
Of course, Dr. Prashant. Mr. Yellappa ji, based on the symptoms given in your letter, pest is woolly aphid. This pest incidence will be more in crops provided with chemical nitrogen fertilizers. Chemical control is with SFH 75 SP 2 kgs in 1000 liters of water towards the underleaf surface. We at our institute developed botanical technique. Take Castadapi leaves 2 kgs, Pongamia leaves 2 kgs and Ipomia leaves 2 kgs with 500 ml of neem oil in 8 to 10 liters of hot water. Keep the contents for 24 to 36 hours. Grind the contents and filter it. Add 200 grams of soap powder. Mix 2 liters of this solution with 15 liters of water and use as foliar spray. Hope this solution would resolve your problem.
Thank you, Dr. Chandrika. Your valuable suggestion will help a lot of our farmers. So second letter is from Devendra of Kolhapur district of Maharashtra. He would like to know why these shoots of a sugarcane crop are converted into a long whip-like structure. Dear Devendra Paji, Dr. Nitika will offer a piece of advice to your query. Dr. Nitika, please.
Thank you, Dr. Prashant. Dear Devendra Appaji, it is a smut disease caused by fungal pathogen. The smut infection in the sugarcane crop is mainly due to use of infected planting material. The affected plants show stunted growth and the central shoot is converted into a long whip-like dusty black structure. So, for its proper management, I would like to suggest you to use the healthy plant sets and to remove and destroy the smutted clump. Collect the whips in a thick cloth bag or polythene bag or immerse it in a boiling water for 1 hour to kill the spores. Discourage the ratooning of the infected crop having infection up to 10% and pre-treatment of the cane sets in by dipping it in 2.5% organomercurial fungicide, which helps to reduce the incidence. Hope these practices will take care of your sugarcane smut disease.
Thank you, Dr. Nitika. Your valuable suggestion would help a lot of our farmers. Next query is from Basavaraj of Belgaum district of Karnataka. He has observed reddening in the midrib of leaf tissues and also in the rind of the cane stalks. Dr. Parida, will you please throw some light on the query?
Thank you, Dr. Prasan. Well, dear Basavaraj, based on the symptoms explained by you, the crop is suffering from red rot, a fungal disease. This disease can be controlled by adopting integrated red rot management practices like select the seed cane from a disease-free healthy crop. Soak the seed cane overnight with Pseudomonas and methyl thiophenate. Treat the seed cane in a hot aerated moist condition at 54 degrees centigrade for 1 hour. In rainy season, this disease spreads fast. Bonding may be done to avoid the movement of pathogen through rain and flood water. Severely, these management aspects will help you to overcome red rot disease.
Thank you, Dr. Parida, for your valuable advice. Next query is from Bhushan Bhave of Baramati district of Maharashtra. He is concerned because of stunted growth and reduced yielding seen in his sugarcane field. Dear Bhaveji, Dr. Piyashi will offer her suggestion. Dr. Piyashi, please.
Yeah, sure. Thank you, Dr. Prashant. Well, Bhaveji, the reason for your concern is ratoon stunting disease is caused by a bacteria which has been considered to be an important cause for sugarcane varietal degeneration. Primary spread of the disease is through infected seeds. Secondary spread is through contaminated harvesting implements. Disease clumps usually display stunted growth, reduced tillering, thin stalks with shortened internodes and yellowish foliage. Management practices that you have to follow are: select the seeds from disease-free fields or from disease-free commercial nurseries. Remove and burn the clumps showing the disease incidence. Treat the seeds before planting with 0.2% Bavistin. Bhaveji, hope this would resolve your problem.
Thank you, Dr. Piyashi, for your valuable advice. Next query is from Ramu of Krishnanagar, district of Andhra. He wants to know about his 45 days old sugarcane crop showing drying of central shoot, which is easily coming upon pulling. Dr. Prabhulinga, will you please throw some light on the Ramu's query?
Yeah, sure, Dr. Prashant. Ramuji, based on the symptoms given in our letter, it is a clear-cut case of the early shoot borer of the sugarcane. The problem of this pest is commonly observed in the early shoot borer endemic sugarcane growing area. And this is not due to any disease or not due to any nutrient deficiency. Drying of the central shoot is also called as dead art. This drying is due to the feeding activity of the early stage borer at the base of the central shoot. And the incidence of this pest is commonly observed in the early 1 to 3 month old crop. So this pest can effectively managed by early season planting, that is during December, January, or soil application of the carbapuram 3G at the rate of 33 kg per hectare, or spraying of the chloropyrifos 20 EC at the rate of 2 ml per liter of water directed towards the central shoot of the crop. Ramuji, hope this solution will help you to manage this important pest of the sugarcane.
Thank you, Dr. Prabhulinga. Ramesh ji from Udol wants to know about wilting patches in his 8-month-old crop. Dr. Prakash, will you throw some light on his query?
Of course, Dr. Prashant, I am happy to throw some light on it. Well, Ramesh ji, complete wilting of sugarcane in patches is due to the feeding activity of root grub. Root grub feed on the plant so that the plant cannot take up the nutrient and water, resulting in wilting. To prevent this, you either apply metarhizium at the rate of 3 to 4 kg per hectare along with the farmyard manure, or spray with chloropyrifos at the rate of 2 ml per liter of water. The former is effective for controlling the larval root grub and the latter for the adult. Ramesh ji, I am sure if you follow this measure, you will definitely overcome the problem of root grub.
Thank you, Dr. Prakash. Dear farmer friends, until now, we have listened to our plant protection experts. Now, I request Dr. Pardeep Kumar to throw some light on the pest and disease resistant varieties developed at his institute. Dr. Pardeep Kumar, please.
Yes, sure. It's my pleasure, Prashant. Dear farmer friends, the major disease and insect resistant varieties developed our institute are CoLK8102, CoLK8001, are high tillering, no lodging, very good ratooner, and resist and yielder varieties, which are resistant to red rot, smut, wilt, and ratoon stunting under field condition. Yield 90 to 100 tons per hectare. Co0403 is a early medium thick cane without spine and resistant to red rot and smut. Its yield 101.5 tons per hectare. Karan 8 is a high sugar early maturing variety, medium thick yellow cane and resistant to the prevalent races of red rot and stem borer, and is also high yielding variety with 100 to 105 tons per hectare. By cultivating these resistant varieties, you may protect your crop by various insect and disease.
Thank you, Dr. Pardeep Kumar, for your valuable suggestion. Now, let us know about the specific agronomic practices that have to be followed. Our agronomist, Dr. Panjavarnam, will share our experience. Dr. Panjavarnam, please.
Well, Dr. Prasant, I would like to say that one should select a good quality planting material that is free from aerial roots and splits. There are some special practices which has to be done to increase yield as well as manage pests and diseases. In these special practices, earthing up at 120 days after planting, coinciding with peak tillering stage, and detrassing after can formation around 150 days after planting. And finally, cropping has to be done to check the lodging of the can. By these management practices, you can achieve a higher can yield.
Thank you, Dr. Panjavarnam. And I also thank all our experts, Dr. Chandrika, Dr. Parida, Dr. Prabhulinga, Dr. Pardeep Kumar, Dr. Nitika, Dr. Piyashi Debroy, Dr. Prakash Sharma, for coming to our studio and sharing your knowledge with your farmer friends. Dear farmers, we have reached the end of our program. Hope the information suggested by our experts will be very useful for your sugarcane farming. If you have any further queries, kindly contact us at Kisan Seva, post box number 3462, Nam, Hyderabad, or you may also email us. Our email ID is kisanseva@nam.in, or you may visit our website at www.kisanseva.nam.in. Well, dear farmer friends, hope you have enjoyed our program. We shall meet in the next episode with another interesting topic. Till then, keep writing to us. Namaste.